These flights are against the law and got me in trouble, so today I'm going to explain all of the rules that you need to follow while flying. Most people don't realize that flying car laws already exist, and the consequences are huge if you don't follow them. From dodging power lines and red lights to flying in big cities for the Spider-Man movie, I learned all of this the hard way and almost lost everything. Today I break down exactly what happened and explain 7 simple rules to keep you out of trouble. Then we test these rules and set up a flight in one of the hardest places to fly. If anything else goes wrong, they can shut us down for good. It all started right here. This is the first video of me flying that ever hit the internet, and it broke it. Within 3 days, the government tracked me down and said,
"You violated federal regulations."
I had secretly been developing the SkySurfer aircraft for 10 years, but that night, I decided to break free from my little testing area and fly around the corner to grab a late night snack. I didn't realize that the air belongs to the government in the United States, and if you're flying, that means you're on their property. So no matter where you are, you have to do whatever they say. When they tell me to jump, I can only ask how high, and that's because I designed the SkySurfer aircraft into the ultralight vehicle category, which they already have laws for. Here's the exact part that got me in trouble. I've been stopping at red lights my whole life. It felt like the right thing to do, but now it's literally against the law. Right there, I touched the ground. That 1 second is what triggered everything. When I did that, I technically landed an aircraft on the road, which is only allowed for emergency situations. Knowing that, I decided to fly to lunch the next day and thought that all I need to do is make sure I don't touch the road and I'll be good. That's when I quickly started to realize that the government polices the air more than they do the ground. I've been talking about flying to lunch for years. The plan was simple. It'll take 19 minutes to fly there and back, but I only have 20 minutes of flight time, so no detours. This was my first time flying way up in the sky with total freedom. No roads, no red lights, just open air. It felt incredible. Until I got another phone call. Here's the exact moment that got me in trouble. After that, they tracked me down and said,
"Your aircraft does not have a way to land in an emergency, and for that reason, you are never allowed to fly over power lines."
Now, in an emergency, I don't just fall out of the sky. One of the most important parts of the SkySurfer aircraft design was making sure it has backups of everything, so we're working on getting this all changed. But until then, rule number 2, don't fly over power lines.
You're only allowed so many mistakes, so I wish it stopped there, but then I found out that even if you're flying in your own backyard, the government is still watching you.
A few days later, some good news finally came in. A reality TV show was asking if I wanted to fly on it. Unfortunately, they said it has to be today, but after a decade in the garage, I figured this might finally be my chance to show the world everything I've been working on. The problem here is that if something looks unsafe while you're flying, the government gets triggered and starts digging. I don't think they were happy with any of this, because I did have to explain it's a TV show, it's made to look like chaos. But even on a controlled set with actors, safety checks, and even COVID testing, the optics still matter. On top of that, the biggest issue happened right here. The laws say you're not allowed to fly directly over people, so after seeing that, my phone started to ring. I'm on someone's radar now, and they're watching my every move.
I didn't realize that right now, all these videos are spreading across the world without me, so once people realize where these videos are coming from, things are going to get crazier.
On day 6, I flew to the famous skate park at Venice Beach. I wanted to see how difficult it is to fly inside the bowls with all of the wind pushing back at me, but it turns out there's an airport 3 miles away. Since I'm an aircraft, I'm not allowed to leave the ground, so they all fell out of their chairs when they saw this. They said before flying here, I'm supposed to call into air traffic control at the airport and ask them if I can enter the air, which, as we know, is their property. This is the same thing that all airplanes do, and later when we set up a flight, I'll show you how all this is done. So, before you fly, you need to check a map and see if you're even allowed to take off. It'll tell you what airspace you're flying in and help you figure out how strict the rules are.
A few days later, I found myself in a situation where I'm throwing all my stuff into the car and driving across the country because I just got the opportunity to fly in the Spider-Man movie as the Green Goblin. This all sounds really cool, but in real life, it was just rough.
This is a bigger stage, so I've got a stunt coordinator this time, and he saved me. Right before taking off, there was one thing he said to me that changed how I flew. He said, "Lock your speed, no exceptions." That's the moment our next rule clicked. Did you know there's speed limits in the air? You're not even allowed to build something capable of flying over 63 miles per hour.
That got us in some trouble here while pretending to race a Lamborghini.
The government has an official testing procedure that we have to put the SkySurfer aircraft through in order to see if it's capable of going that fast, but the problem is, I'm too scared to find out how fast it goes.
It's been a few weeks now, and the stakes are rising.
Jack, out of the way.
If we're not careful, the government can lock us to the ground for good. It's time that we go to a new country, but since I'm tired of dealing with all this, we're basically going to just buy our freedom.
This all started when I got the chance to go to Spain with Tom Holland. You might know him as Spider-Man, but this was for his other movie, Uncharted. We wanted to fly at the premiere, but after everything we've learned, we need to be careful. Spain has its own rulebook, and Tom warned me that fans could surge the barricades, so I came up with a ridiculous solution. Let's build a roof over the entire outdoor area. Since I'm on a budget, I got creative with a giant net. You can see it stretched out above me and technically makes this an indoor space, like a cage. And if I'm in a cage, I don't have any freedom anymore. I'm no longer an aircraft flying through the air. I'm just a guy in a really weird box, but legally that changes everything. And for once, it gives me total freedom.
Now that we're out of strikes, it's time to use everything we've learned and set up a flight the right way in one of the most difficult situations possible. I just got the opportunity to fly down the red carpet at the Spider-Man movie premiere. Any mistakes here would mean game over, so let's stop guessing and take control.
Even if you're just trying to fly to the grocery store, this is the same process. Step one, get permission to leave the ground. Let's start by opening the same map from earlier and find the location that we need to fly at. It says there's an airport 5 miles away, so that makes this a controlled airspace, which is a difficult one. To fly here, we have to call the airport and ask air traffic control for permission to be in the air. Since every airplane and helicopter has to do this, we all have radios so that you can call in from anywhere within seconds. So let's say you're standing on the side of the road and ready to take off. Well, what are we saying to the radio? That was Mark. He's a helicopter pilot and has a lot of experience flying in the military. All pilots talk way too fast, but if we make him slow it down, the official radio call sounds like this.
Santa Monica Tower, ultralight SkySurfer, outside Delta Northeast. Request 100 foot radius, at or below 5 feet AGL, 10 minutes, center point coordinates available.
When I officially called in to make the request, we all had a good laugh because I'm flying only a few feet over a carpet and they're used to dealing with airplanes, but this is required. Get some proof that you did what you're supposed to. You might be wondering if you need a license to fly. To answer any question you might have, I created a page on the SkySurfer Aircraft website with all of the official laws for the USA. Now that we have permission to take off, we move to step two, get permission to land. The road and sidewalk belong to the city, so instead of worrying about all that, I got a map of the premiere and asked nearby owners for permission to use their property. Step three, safety. Nothing can even look unsafe, so while we're flying, let's cap the speed, mark a no people zone, place spotters on the line, and bring the red carpet dimensions to my backyard to practice the exact path. If anything looks unsafe, we don't fly.
After all that, we are set up and ready to fly, but they canceled my flight because of rain. The old me would have tried to push it anyway, but today we stand down, and that's the point. The rules aren't here to stop the story, they keep it going. Looking back through all these years of flight footage, it's wild to see how far we've come. This started as a chaotic dream to build a future for personal flight vehicles, but now we have a system. Everything we've learned has become 7 simple rules. Use them alongside all of the official laws on our website and you will be in the clear. Thank you guys for making all of this possible by following along for the journey. 6 models available now at SkySurferAircraft.com.